This is the Syrian Guernica. I drew it in 2017. I merged what Picasso painted with what I felt in the war in Syria. What Picasso saw was really incredible. Picasso had this way of reading, absorbing the pain and shock in a very strong way.
The pain and the shock Ahmed experienced in Syria are still etched on his art. The 40-year-old painter refused to leave his country until one day he was presented with a choice: to flee or join in the fighting.
I was on a bus. I was a teacher, and someone from the military came inside the bus and started asking for IDs. He asked me what was my level of military training in the mandatory service. I didn't want to leave Syria. But to get involved in the war is something else. It's something I could not do.
The most complex conflict to emerge from the Arab Spring, Syria saw outside players arise as powerful foes, fueling the flames of the war within its borders.
The war was not between Syrians only. That's how it started. And that is what it was supposed to be. But then Russia entered the conflict to defend its ally, and it helped with its air weapons.
Iran-backed militia were already providing support for Syria's president, while the opposition counted with financial assistance from Gulf countries. But Russia was to shift the balance of power irreversibly. Mission Syria was launched in September 2015, 2 months after Ahmad left the country.
What you're seeing right now is something I experienced. When my school got bombed, my childhood school, it was a moment like that. I lived such moments multiple times. And this is the image of my family escaping. It's an image that got stuck in my head. There's no way it can be forgotten or removed. It's impossible.
Ahmed's journey took him through Turkey and then Greece towards Northern Europe and Belgium, where he would be given a new chance and a new title, refugee.
It is a new period in my life, a new period that is neither negative or positive, but it's a new time that I could say I am without a country, or that maybe I am looking for a new country for me and for my family. The problem is that I don't know if the word refugee will stick with me. I mean, even if I get the European nationality, will I remain a refugee? Or will I be a citizen? In the inside, I don't know if it's a short period or if it's going to be permanent.